Welcome back. Let's get a market conversation going now. Sachin Shah, fund manager at Emkay Investment Managers, is with us to discuss the market fundamentals. Sachin, good to have you on the show. So it's quite interesting. I mean, the Nifty has gradually taken these baby steps and moved back to the zone of 10,700. Do you see higher levels ahead?
Well, you know, as you know that we are in the midst of an earnings season, that's number one. Number two, we also have this state election results coming up in the next 1 week or so. That's number two. And number three, we also have some bit of headwinds from the, some of the global data points in terms of higher oil prices, which does affect Indian economy, and overall also, bond yields going higher in the U.S. markets. So I think at this point in time, probably markets will be more like a wait and watch mode. Nevertheless, what we have also seen is that in this earnings season, most of the results have been fairly in line with the expectations. So there has been no major disappointments. That's number one. And number two, which is a silver lining, is that in some of the result management result commentaries, what we are seeing is that they all are quite optimistic that the rural demand and aggregate demand at that from that side is actually coming back. So which is a very, very positive thing, I would like to say. After almost 2 years, we are hearing this kind of commentary from a lot of businesses which are actually playing out in the rural areas. So I think overall the undertone remains fairly buoyant. Just that I think this, for some time the markets may remain in this small trading zone before it actually starts moving up in the next zone.
Okay. Sachin, wanted your thoughts on whether you track Strides Shasan and the news which has come out right now?
Well, actually, I'm sorry, but I do not really track this company.
Okay. What would your view be on mid-cap pharma in any case?
Well, you know, pharma has always been actually more like a bottoms-up kind of a business to me, because every business has its own products, regions. So there are a lot of, combinations that actually go through. Very clearly, some of the pharma companies, particularly in large caps and mid caps, both I would say, where the models were based on the high growth of the U.S. markets, they are taking a backseat at this point in time. Domestic markets also, there has been some bit of, shaking up in the last few quarters, more to do with the demonetization and then the GST. Of course, things have now settled down quite well. So I think it's going to be very, very company specific rather than making a sectoral call on a mid-cap pharma or overall pharma per se.
Sachin, you mentioned that there have been no disappointments in the earnings season. So the one sector that everybody has their eye on is obviously IT. Given the run-up in stock prices, both large caps and mid caps, do you still have more comfort buying any of these stocks afresh?
So, if you look back a little, say maybe 6 months back, probably they were one of the most attractively valued stocks, if I can say so. In terms of the PE multiples, they were not really, really expensive, and the kind of the cash flows that this business is generate, and in terms of tons of cash flow, actually, I would say, there are a few opportunities like that in the country. So obviously, the markets have kind of recognized. Plus, you also have rupee depreciation, which has happened from almost 63, 64 to 67. That helps them a bit to take care of some of the headwinds that they've had in the last last couple of years. Also, outlook on the U.S. economy is getting better. We are seeing that the U.S. corporates, with the kind of the tax savings that they will have, probably their investments will actually increase, and that should also help some bit, to some of these companies over here. So overall, I think they should probably be able to do some kind of a maybe single digit to, maybe low double digit kind of a growth for the next 12 to 18 months. So in that sense, today at this point in time, yes, if an investor is expecting a 12 to 15% kind of a return, it's quite possible that if you invest at this point in time, there's a good probability of you earning that kind of returns.
Okay. All right, Sachin, we're going to leave it on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and talking to us. We need to take a break now.